So in Revelation chapter number 9, they had a king over them, which is the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name in the Hebrew is Abaddon, but in the Greek tongue hath his name Apollyon. This is 2015. The church is dead and asleep. The only crowds you have in this country today are the crowds that are pumped up by rock and rap, and it's all about love, self-love and positive attitudes, and, you know, money and me, myself and I. I'm in love with me, I'm in love with myself, and I'm in love with I. You've got the people to the point to where they can be moved emotionally, not intellectually, but emotionally. Anything stirs people today. They got crowd mentality. They got mob mentality. Can you imagine something that has created earthquakes, that has made apparitions appear, that you've got scientists warning, don't do this, you don't know what you're going to unleash? Maybe there's a greater purpose in all of that that they're not even aware of. He's called Satan. Maybe he intends to bring chaos on this earth. Chaos. Order out of chaos. The peacemaker shows up. And burning, and then the peacemaker shows up. How close could we be to the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ? How close could we be? How close? The church is asleep, but the Lord's coming back.
But the Lord's coming back.
And to hear about something over here that they can produce 1 gram of it has the potential of 4 atomic bombs. Boy, if somebody got a hold of that, you talk about blackmailing a whole nation. And did you know what? They say they're weaponizing it now. And they say now that the nations of the world, although they've joined together over there in Europe with this collider, they've stepped back and thought to themselves, hold on. If this crowd over here gets that, we need that.
We need that.
And there you go. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but I'm going to tell you this morning what I really believe. I really do believe this. I believe that all the peace and prosperity and joy, as far as this world's concerned, that you've enjoyed, enjoy it, because I don't think things are going to get any better. I believe they're going to get worse. And I believe you're just beginning to see the beginning of it, and I believe that war is soon to come. There's going to come an Armageddon apocalypse. I hope you're ready. I hope you're ready. I hope you are. I hope you're ready to meet the Lord. I hope you're ready. My biggest fear of this place over here is not them blowing up the world. Although, the Lord's going to make the decision about that. Here's what I worry about coming out of that place, is all this spirit deception, using it to deceive people. They connect spirituality and science together. Imagine what kind of a union that would have. Science and spirituality.
Science and spirituality.
Not Christ, but science and spirituality joined together. Man, they've got what they want when that happens. How many of you know the Lord Jesus this morning? Boy, even so, come Lord Jesus. Now, folks, I've only had 3 or 4 days to deal with this. I've gotten some stuff in here that I need to go deeper into and look at a little further, because there's some stuff going on here that literally blows my mind. But what I've given out to you this morning is just skimming the surface about what's happening in CERN, Switzerland. Some of you may know a whole lot more about some of this stuff than I do. But if you do, you should be alarmed, because what I've told you, the truth. Folks, this is not hypothetical. If I understand correctly, no more than a handful of matter was used to blow up Hiroshima and Nagasaki. They released the potential in that and blew it up, if I understand it correctly. And that 1 gram of antimatter is 4 times more powerful than what blew up Nagasaki and Hiroshima. You don't want that in the hands of the wrong person. Father, in Jesus' name, I ask you to use what I've said, Lord, for the glory of God. There may be somebody sitting in this house this morning that's awake now. They've wakened up. They're alarmed. And they're worried. And they're thinking, my goodness, if half of what that preacher said is true, that's enough to stir me. I'll do something about it. In Jesus' name.